Welcome to my channel Sara Cooks For You. Today we are going to make a very popular Middle Eastern rice dish called chicken kabsa. This is very simple to make and it's really delicious. You can see not many ingredients also are used for this. I've used one bell pepper which I've cut into squares, two chopped onions, about 5 cloves of garlic finely chopped, 2 tablespoons of tomato paste, 1 large tomato, about 750 grams of chicken legs, and 2 cups of rice, basmati rice. And the dry masalas, I've used turmeric, 1/2 a teaspoon, 1 teaspoon coriander, 3/4 teaspoon cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of curry powder, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 3/4 teaspoon pepper powder, salt to taste, 2 green cardamoms, 3 cloves and 1 cinnamon stick. Apart from this, I'll be using some oil and butter. 2 bay leaves and 2 dried lemons. If you don't have the dried lemon, you can just add some lemon juice, fresh lemon juice to this. To begin this recipe, I'm going to put some oil in a pan. Make sure you take a bigger dish because you're going to cook the rice in this itself. And I'm going to add a little bit of oil and a little bit of butter. So add accordingly. Butter, I'm adding about 1 big tablespoon of butter. And about 7 to 8 tablespoons of oil. Once the oil is heated, I'm going to add the finely chopped garlic into the butter and oil mixture. Just fry this for a few seconds and then add in the sliced onions. This is a really quick recipe and it is really tasty also. And it's a one pot recipe, so it's very convenient. I fried these onions till they are golden brown. And I'm adding the chicken pieces. I've used full legs. So I'm just adding all of them. Just fry them for a minute, just flip them over. You can use the whole chicken, the mixed chicken parts also. I'm just using the legs. You can add whatever pieces you like. And I'm adding in all the masalas, the bay leaves, the garam masala, and all the other masalas into this. Just mix everything together. I'll fry this for just about 2 minutes. Add in the lemons and the capsicum. And all the other ingredients, the chopped tomato. I'm adding in about 2 glasses of water for the chicken to cook. The rice is going to get cooked in this broth. I've added a soup cube, the chicken cube, which is Maggi or Knorr. You can use any thing that's available. This is optional. This adds to the taste, so I'm just adding 1 cube which I have crushed. And about 2 tablespoons of tomato paste. So we'll add this also to the mixture. Mix it well and taste for the chili and salt. and close the lid and we'll allow the chicken to cook well in this. I've cooked the chicken well. So the stock is ready. We're going to add the rice to this stock. I'm going to remove the chicken pieces from this. And I'm placing it on a sheet of foil. And this will go into the oven. I'm just making some holes in the chicken with a fork. And I've added oil to this. Just brush some oil over the pieces, chicken pieces. And since they would have got bland because they've been boiled there in the broth. So I'm going to add some spices to this, like black pepper, chili powder or paprika. You can sprinkle on these pieces. This again is optional, but I'm just adding it to make it more flavorful. And I'm just going to brush the remaining oil over this so that the seasoning sticks to the chicken well. They coat the chicken well. And I've put it in the oven to bake them. And in the meantime, we'll add this soaked rice into the chicken stock. So check the water accordingly. Now we've added 2 cups of rice. Make sure you already have water. Remember, you have water in the pot as well. So generally for 2 cups rice, you use 4 cups of water, but there's water already in the stock. So add accordingly. I've removed the chicken from the oven. They are really done well. It's got a nice barbecued look on it and the rice is also ready. And for the sauce to be served along with this rice, I've added 1 large tomato, 2 green chilies, some cloves of garlic, about 2 cloves of garlic. You can also add onion, half an onion, that's optional, and some coriander leaves. Salt to taste, and if you like it a little sour, then you can add some lemon juice also to this. And olive oil also is optional. I'm adding some tomato paste also, about 1/2 teaspoon. And let's chop this. I've put it in the chopper so you can see we don't have to grind this to a paste. I've done it in the chopper. So I'm just going to add some water to get it to the right consistency. And the sauce to go with the chicken is ready. Plate the rice and place the chicken pieces on top of the rice and serve it hot along with the chutney or the sauce that we have made.